How's it going, everyone? It's Abdallah here, bringing you guys another tips and tricks video for Animal Crossing New Horizons. Today's video is giving you guys the perfect guide in order to complete and teach you everything about Rover's May Day Maze within the game. I'm so pumped for this one. The video is going to be divided up into four different parts, so make sure you guys pay attention closely. The first one is going to show you guys exactly how to access the maze within your specific game. The next thing we're going to do is show you how to beat the maze 100% within 5 minutes. And of course, we will then show you guys what you get from beating the maze. And last but not least, we're going to take it to the comment section and we are going to answer 20 frequently asked questions about May Day in general so that you guys have all the information at your fingertips. Thanks so much for watching. Now, if you guys didn't already come on board as a subscriber, it's absolutely free and we've got tons of Animal Crossing content available to you. So make sure that you guys take a look at it. One of our recent videos that we put on board was the Feng Shui Guide. There's a lot of misinformation about luck in the game and different spawns and all that stuff. And we put it to the test and the results are very, very intriguing. So make sure you check that one out. All right, so without further ado, let's jump on into exactly what May Day is all about. Our first step is going to be making sure your game is up to date. So click on the home menu icon and then click on plus on your game. Make sure that you're on May 1st. Everyone's May 1st may be in a different region, so keep that in mind. Now, Isabel will announce exactly that it is May Day, and she'll tell you to go talk to Tom Nook over here in Resident Services. Now, May Day is going to be a way of saying thanks to everyone that works hard, and it's kind of a way that we can just kind of relax and solve a little cool puzzle. And I do like this kind of content. So what he says is he's going to give you a May Day ticket at the desk of the Dodo Airlines. This is not something that you're going to have in your hand. So no, you cannot trade your May Day ticket for 20 Nook Miles or anything like that. That is not a thing. It's going to be locked specifically with your name on it at the desk of the Dodos over here. So keep that in mind. Once you touch down over on May Day Island, you'll be greeted with empty pockets. And you're going to have to go through an entire maze. Now, if you guys have seen my previous two videos where we replicated this exact maze, you already know exactly what's happening. But if you guys haven't, we have the answers for you right here. So here we are at Rover's May Day Maze. There's two solutions that you can use in order to get to the end. There's a speed run where you just go straight to Rover, or there's a perfect 100% route, and that's exactly the route that we're gonna show you. And by doing the perfect route, you will be netting a whole bunch of Bell Voucher tickets that you can take home and make that easy money. So, as you guys can see, you can set the timer right now. It's going to be a really fun one. All you have to do is grab that shovel and start off. You're going to be able to jump over here as soon as you grab that bush out of the way. Eat the cherry. Very simple. And by eating one cherry, you're going to get one power-up. And the power-up will allow you to grab trees completely out of the ground with the shovel. And that's going to be a big plan in this entire maze here. So, moving on over this way, we're going to be collecting these three woods, and this will help us with crafting our iron axe towards the end of this maze. And that's the beauty about this maze entirely, is that you're going to be able to craft a couple different things in order to help you progress through it. So you'll notice over here that we grabbed the branch along the way, and we're going to continue heading towards the east here. But before we continue going there, we want to jump downwards to all of these and grab every single one of these branches. You'll notice that there's a brand new tool over here. This tool is called the Worn Axe. We have not seen that before, but a Worn Axe is sharp enough to chop down a tree, but it only has 3 hits on it. So you're only able to chop down one singular tree with it. Will a Worn Axe come available in the main series games outside of these little puzzles? I highly doubt it, but I think that it's pretty intriguing that they made this specifically with that durability. So, very excited for that. So, you do the 3 hits on this tree in the corner over here, and then you're going to have access to this next branch and 2 cherries. Now, with these stumps, it really doesn't matter. If you want to dig them out, feel free to do so. It's probably a little bit faster if you're able to just sit on it and then rotate around. Very easy. Okay, so now that we have 2 cherries in our inventory, we are going to have to go break some rocks. Returning right over here is going to allow us to attack this singular rock. So what I want to do is I want to eat this cherry and then use the shovel in order to break that. Now breaking that will give us access to the iron nugget, and the iron nugget is going to be used for our iron axe. Heck, we already have the ingredients for pretty much all of it. So what we have to do now is work our way clockwise all the way back around this way in order to go to the rock that's on the other side of the maze. Now, once we have the rock on the other side of the maze, we're going to eat another cherry. So, very simple. It's going to be the exact same concept. So, eating the cherry allows us to break this rock. And if you're a brand new player, they're actually giving you the DIY recipes for a flimsy axe, and they're giving you the DIY recipe for a regular axe. So, to give you the hints of what you need to craft. I think that's pretty awesome. It's making sure that everyone is accessible to this thing. So, if you're a day one player and you wanted to go to talk to Tom Nook, you can fly out here today. So, if you didn't already see here, I grabbed a cherry, ate it, and then now I was able to come in here and jump across and then access this crafting table. Now, with the crafting table, this is exactly where you're going to use those two DIY recipes. One of them is going to be the flimsy axe. Since we crafted and grabbed all of the little branches that were strewn about and that specific stone, we were able to craft that. Now that we have the flimsy axe craftable, we're going to use the iron nugget and then the three pieces of wood along with the flimsy axe in order to make a stronger one, which will allow us to chop down all of the remaining trees on this island. So we're ready to go. Grab that axe, and then we are going to head straight to the west this way, and we're going to chop down a tree in order to give ourselves two additional cherries. Now, once we have these two cherries, there's really only one more cherry left on the map, which will net us all the cherries that we need in order to get the extra credit at the very end, which will constitute as the perfect run within the game. So now that we're here, we're going to move upwards, and we're going to jump across. And we're going to come right down this way, and we're pretty much going to go the exact same path that we took in order to get to the stone and the iron nugget. But since we've already broken that out of the way, we can use the axe that's in our inventory over here, and we can chop this down. And by chopping this down, this is going to net us the answers to the final stretch. This is it right here. All we have to do is move along this linear path. There's nothing else. We have completely finished this map. This is our third cherry that's in our inventory, and I showed that to you guys right over here. Now, this is going to be the exact same thing. Just chopping this down. One, two, three, sit, rotate. One, two, three, sit, rotate, and then do the exact same thing. And ladies and gents, congratulations. You guys beat the entire maze. But don't celebrate just yet, because there's a couple things that I do want to show you guys. You know those yellow tickets over there, right? We're absolutely going to get every single one of them. Heck, this is the perfect run after all. So now that we're here, you can talk to Rover. Hey, Rover's here. And he's pretty much saying, hey, you know, maybe I've seen you somewhere and it's my first time on the island. And oh, you know Tom Nook? Hey, that's really great. He probably sent me here too. So he's just really giving you a little bit of small talk, a little bit of paying homage to who this character is. And those of you guys newer to the series, he's a character that you start off with at the very beginning of the game. And he introduces you to your specific town. And based on the questions that he asks you and your answers, your facial features are enabled over there. So you can talk to him a couple more times, but now is the time where we're going to run over here and we're going to grab everything. Now, forgive me for leaving this fast forward, but you're just going to walk all the way across the island. You're going to eat the last remaining of your three cherries, and you're going to break these for the remaining bell vouchers. Super easy. And then you can dig your way out to seeing exactly the end right over here. Ta-da! Yeah, we did it. Awesome. So if you ever get stuck, I do want to let you know that you can use the Mr. Rossetti Rescue Call Center in order to get yourself way back to the beginning, which is not bad. And even if you did beat the entire map and obtain the specific item from Rover, which is his briefcase, you'll be able to redo the entire maze again, which is really fun. So if you guys want to work on a speed run of doing the exact same thing, where you start with the shovel and then you end with getting your last ticket, you can try for that. But other than that, there's really no reason to do the entire thing. So once you're done with that, head on over to the Wilbur guy over here and let him know that you're ready to go. For some reason, he doesn't allow you to take the bell vouchers or your briefcase home, so he mails it over to you. You guys will be able to see that right over here. Once you check your mail, as soon as you arrive on the island, you don't have to let a day pass. You're going to see that you have the Rover's briefcase, and you'll be able to have all those bell vouchers. Now, if you take a look over here, you'll be able to see all these different stickers on there that pay homage to the Animal Crossing series. Every single sticker has its own unique thing to it. Yeah, I like it. I like it a lot. And they even included Crazy Red. So here we are. Now that you guys learned a lot about Rover and Mayday, I'm going to take it a step further and teach you guys even more things based off of frequently asked questions in my comments and live stream about the entire Mayday event. So I've written over 15, about 20 of them down, so that you guys can get even more information. Hopefully it helps. Here we go. Is the island different every trip? No, it is not. It is going to be the exact same island. What islands spawn on May 2nd, May 3rd, May 4th, 6th, 7th? Nothing. The exact same island is spawned every single day. Is the maze going to be timed? No, it's not. You can take your time with it. You can take your 5 minutes with it. Can you bring anything with you? No, you can't. What rewards do you get from Rover? You just get Rover's briefcase. What items do you get from the island tour? Well, you get Rover's briefcase and you get the bell voucher tickets if you decided to go through the specific path in order to get them. You can't take any of the bushes or trees or anything like that home. Can you use a ticket after the window of opportunity? Well, the window of opportunity is only from the 1st to the 7th and you are not going to be able to do that. So you have to make sure you log in and do that between those dates. Are cherries there or are they your native fruits? They are your native fruits, absolutely. Cherries are my native, so that's exactly what it's shown over there. What's the point of Mayday and these mazes? Well, it's just to get some cool items and just to say thanks, right? Here's some extra content in the game. What is Mayday? Well, if you were listening to Tom Nook at the beginning, he says it's a day where we express our gratitude to those who work hard, like all of you guys. What's the difference between the Northern Hemisphere and the Southern Hemisphere? There's no difference. It's the exact same event. Can you buy another ticket in the ABD? No, you cannot, unfortunately. Can another live-in villager claim a ticket? Yes, absolutely, but it's only for them. A ticket is not an item that you can have in your inventory. It's at the desk of the dodos. So I have an alternate account, which is Jess, and I went over there and got my ticket from Nook. He says he's going to put it over there at the dodo spot, and you can't physically hand it over to another person. Can you sell Rover's briefcase? Yeah, you can for 2,000 bells. Can you get another ticket by time traveling back to 4:30 and then going one day forward to May 1st? No, you can't. I've tried it on stream. Can Rover move to the island? No, he's just an NPC and he's there for that one reason and that one reason only. Are you able to see Rover's avatar in Harv's Island? If you have access to the Animal Crossing amiibo, you absolutely can summon him in there. And he's kind of cool. You can also summon Reese and Cyrus too. Can you go to the year 2021, or a year after that, or a year after that, insert any year here, and get another ticket? As of right now, you can't. I've tried it on stream. Can you customize the briefcase? No, those stickers are on there for good. And last but not least, can you reorder the briefcase? No, can't do it. So there you have it, guys. Everything you need to know about Animal Crossing's Mayday Tour and Rover within the game. Did this video help you out? If it did, be sure to give a big thumbs up and share the video with a friend. We've got tons more Animal Crossing that we're working on every single day, so I'd love to have you guys on board. We do live streams, tips and tricks, tutorial videos. It's a great time, so click on that subscribe button right now. We've got 718,000 of you guys on board. We're gonna hit 1 million in 2020. I know we're gonna do it, and we can't do it without your help. So consider becoming a member, click on the videos on screen over here in order to watch even more content, and also join the Discord, discord.gg/Abdallah. We'll see you guys on the next one. Take care.